Hey everyone, welcome to the Interacty tutorial. In this video, I'll guide you through creating your first digital sliding puzzle. This can be particularly useful for businesses by asking customers to solve a quick puzzle for a chance to win a discount. And of course, it can also serve as a brain teaser for your child or students if you're a teacher. It's quick and simple, so let's jump right into the tutorial. To get started, head over to Interacty Me. If you already have an account, log in. If not, sign up to create a new Interacty profile. Once logged in, click on the Template Gallery button at the top of the screen. Look for the Sliding Puzzle feature and select it. Now, you'll see a page with various templates. You can start with a blank template or choose a pre-made one and customize it. For this tutorial, I'll start from scratch with a simple template. Click Use This Template. Fantastic! You're now in the editor. To begin editing your game, click Edit. Everything is simple. In the Game Type section, pick Image or Numbers based on your preference. Let's choose Image for our example and create a simple marketing minigame to raffle discounts or prizes among playing customers. In the Layout section, pick the preferred difficulty for your sliding puzzle. Let's choose the easiest variation, making the mini game simple and fast for all customers to engage and get their discount coupon. You can also show numbers on tiles or show cover before your game starts. These settings are optional, so use them if needed. The only thing left is to add an image to our sliding puzzle. Click Change. If you have an image on your computer, upload it using the Upload Image button. If not, no worries. We have a free image library for you. Click Free Photos by Unsplash. Enter your desired keyword. Pick an image and click Next. Since our sliding puzzle has a square shape, crop the image accordingly. Select the image and click Place Image. That's it. Click Next to set up your final screen. This is the message users will see after completing your sliding puzzle. Include a congratulatory text and an image. As our game is designed for business purposes, it's generally advised to feature a general prize to capture attention, while also offering discount codes to all participants. Then, include a relevant image and click Save. Your sliding puzzle is ready. You can keep it as is or add additional features to customize your game further. Let's discuss them. On the right side of your screen, select a color theme. Let's go with red to complement our picture. Decide whether you want to mark correct tiles, then choose the color for this highlight. Also, remember to indicate whether you'd like to include a shuffle button. This feature enables users to shuffle the cards and restart the game. You can also incorporate player ratings or a timer to challenge users to complete your puzzle faster. The next settings block is crucial for businesses. You can embed a lead form in your project, requiring users to fill it out to get their discount. Since we recognize the effectiveness of gamification in maximizing email lead generation, we are adding a lead form. To win, customers will need to leave their full name along with their email address. Equally important are the call to action button and redirect options, enabling you to direct users to your website. Let's add a button leading to your website. Add a button text and enter the link to your website. Once you're done, click Preview to evaluate your project. test your sliding puzzle on different devices. If you spot errors or want to make adjustments, return to the editor. Now, give your project a title. Let's name ours Sliding Puzzle Mini Game. After that, click Publish. Your project is ready. Share it with your audience by sending a link or embedding it on your website. We've reached the end of our tutorial. Now you can create sliding puzzles on any topic that interests you. Best of luck!